Previously on Safari Fashion.
Designers, this week's challenge will be to design a gown and make a garment that can be worn on a red carpet event.
My creation is more of something elegant.
Today was very busy.
This time I decided to be overambitious.
Welcome to the search of Kenya's best fashion designer. With 10 challenging tasks, their skills will be tested to the absolute limit. There'll be drama, there'll be tears, some ripped seams, but in the end, only the best designer will survive. The final three designers will then get to showcase their collections at the Safari Fashion Gala Night, but only one will win. Hello, designers.
Hi.
I hope you've been keeping well. Now, you guys put up a sizzling show in the last elimination. So good that the judges had difficulty picking out the best. But of course, in the end, a decision had to be made. Now, it's a new day today, new task. I hope you guys are up for it. Now, the judges mentioned that your work has been steadily improving, so you guys keep it up. Make the job even harder this time around. Yeah? All right, so Sally is going to come in and she'll be giving you the details of your next challenge. Good luck, guys. Break a leg.
Good morning, designers. Mm-hmm. Let's look at last week's challenge. We had a winner, and the winner also won immunity, and that was Steven. Steven, how does it feel?
Wow. It feels good.
It feels good. Yeah. You said it was not easy?
It's not easy to get that.
Yeah? But you got one anyway.
So it's a good feeling.
Yeah? Congratulations. Your challenge this week is to design an avant-garde garment. Now, there's a twist in this garment. This challenge, you will only have 2 days to complete this garment, and you will work in pairs. Now, designers, you will use your imagination, you will be innovative, and you'll be creative in this challenge so that you can bring the best out of this challenge. But before I leave, we need to choose the pairing. Now, the only person who's allowed to pick a person is Steven because of immunity. So, Steven, who would you like to work with? So, Steven and Elsie, okay? The rest of you, it has to be our balloting. Before you, don't open them. Pick. 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 Okay. So open up. Okay then. What number do you have?
Number two.
Wow. Number three. Wow. And number?
Four.
Wow. No, you're not allowed to. You're not allowed to do that. Now, the next thing is that you will meet with Peggy, who will give you further instructions. Thank you. Our challenge begins. You've been told one person is going home tomorrow. Elimination is tomorrow, so you really, really must give it your all. We have your fabrics. We are going to have work with, actually, it's avant-garde. This is where we want to see your creativity. You have bits and pieces of rubbish and fabric and everything, name it. In no order, team 1, 2, 3, 4. Just pick what it is. One bag, just pick a bag, one bag.
This challenge is very interesting. It's avant-garde and it's 2 days. We have only today and tomorrow is runway, so it's a bit tasky. I'm surprisingly happy with my partner. In the beginning, I didn't imagine we could be able to work together because I know he's a very opinionated person, but surprisingly we had almost similar ideas that could gel together and work well together, and we're working very well together. He's doing his thing, I'm doing my thing, and we are very easy. I'm surprised, I take back my words. Steve is not difficult to work with, he's actually very easy.
What I can say about working with my partner, it's an opportunity to know how he works, and so far we are cooperating, we are working well together, and we hope that we'll be able to finish the challenge by tomorrow.
Okay, for the challenge, me, I was ready for anything. It's a challenge. We can, as I told you in the morning, it can be conventional team challenge. I never knew it was going to be a team challenge, so I wasn't surprised. My partner, I'm the one who chose her, so I'm hoping for the best tomorrow.
Once you're ready to begin, once you've sketched, then I think we'll get the bondings, the wires, the water, and we see that just in case there's something that is missing here. then we'll also be able to start from who is your muse and who am I dressing? What if, you know, what kind of, yes, it is out of the world, but then what again, if you think it goes like, you know,
right.
You use your strengths to, very good in sewing, very good fashion forward thinking and all that, and all that put together, you see. So no one's weakness is really like, So once you've done this, then, and you've sketched and you think you're ready, then just think the wires, the what, all that together, so that we bring it together. See if we have a missing link, we see if, how we can be able to bridge that.
With that material. So this dress has sleeves. I can see the silk.
Oh, no, it's a sketch.
The winner of the Safari Fashion Runway will receive a cash prize of 1 million Kenya shillings, a fashion spread of their winning collection at the Couture Africa magazine, retail space for 6 months at the SK collection, plus retail space for one whole year at the Dukalangu online shop, 1 year membership at the Association of Fashion Designers of Kenya, a 1 year scholarship at the Mercantile School of Fashion Design, a professional portfolio photo shoot done by Focus Photography, a customized fashion website by Wageni Technologies, a beauty hamper by Oriflame worth 50,000 Kenya shillings.
Sema, if you in a style, like in a bucket hanging at a cat like me.
Oh, he hung a year around him.
Yeah.
Hello, designers.
Hi.
I trust you've been well. Now, your challenge this week had you working in pairs to create an avant-garde look. Each team received African printed cotton fabric and you had one day to create your garment. Now, in design, avant-garde is seen as an outlet, and that is what the judges will be looking for today. Now, Stephen, you won the red carpet challenge last time and you received immunity. That means you will not be up for elimination today. Now, designers, I'd love to introduce your judges. First, guest judge, well-known international music icon, Marcy Myra. All right, and you have Sally Carago, who is fashion designer and founder of the Markensel School of Fashion Design. Daniel Porti, African fashion PR consultant.
Hi, designers.
And Kathy Obam, a well-known Kenyan fashion designer.
Hello, designers.
Now, designers, judges, I'm sure we're all very eager. So let the show begin.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was fantastic. Designers, we have seen what you have done. I think it was a fantastic job.
Mm-hmm.
Now would like you to leave the runway so we can have a little chat with the judges.
Mm.
Thank you. Judges, let's talk about what you've just seen. What do you think of the first comment that was made by Stephen and Elsie?
Well, I felt like, man, the creativity blew my mind.
Mm-hmm.
But at the bottom, the roses, it just felt like, okay, this is remnants. Okay, let's just tie it together and just throw them in. And there were different colors, which is fine, but it felt like, what's going on down here? I love it. It just completely distracted me.
For myself, I felt that the model found it very difficult to work with.
Yeah.
Until she raised it up.
It brought the dress to life.
To life.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Let's talk about Alan and Beatrice. The garment. What do you think about it, Kathy?
Pieces were well done.
Mm.
The execution
absolutely.
And even.
you know, so, and making those triangles, I can assure you it's not an easy job, and there were many. So I think they did a lot of work, and as we said, you could tell or you could guess what it was.
I definitely think it's an unusual case. I like, again, that we can't quite make out whether it's a bird, an angel,
an eagle.
An eagle.
And what kind of bird.
Exactly.
Bird, right?
It is a bird.
So I'm also curious to see what they were thinking.
Let's look at Wendy and Chicago's garments.
Definitely my favorite. Yes, you see, for me, there was a lot of deep conversation in terms of what you see with the outfit. But then the back of the dress is a thick oven glove with many oven gloves.
Yes.
That's what I saw.
Now, what I saw was the front of it was the representation of mother, and then mother giving birth to earth. As
fertility.
Fertility. Wow. That's what I saw. When she came out, I was like, very creative.
The other person we saw was Ian and Lorna.
My favorite. Definitely rock that. Okay. To a party, to a show, to whatever.
Judges, have you found a winner?
Yes.
Yes. Definitely.
Welcome to the search of Kenya's best fashion designer. With 10 challenging tasks, their skills will be tested to the absolute limit. There'll be drama, there'll be tears, some ripped seams, but in the end, only the best designer will survive. The final three designers will then get to showcase their collections at the Safari Fashion Gala Night, but only one will win. Hi, judges.
Hi.
Hi. That was some mad talent on the catwalk today. What did you guys think?
The creativity just wowed us.
Yeah.
The art.
And even the execution this time.
Yeah.
Great.
Can we have the designers back? And can we also have the models back, please? We want to hear from the designers. Their inspiration, where you got your inspiration from, and what part each designer played in the garment. Yeah. We'll start with you, Ian.
Our design was inspired by the African metamorphosis, being in creativity from a flower. I did the bottom part, and Ian did the top part.
It's a beautiful piece, and Massima.
I would definitely rock it.
She'll definitely rock it. Shikupu and Wendy?
When we were looking at the challenge, at first we thought about it. Our inspiration came from a bird. Then we looked at a bird as a whole, then we said that won't give us a whole story to work on. So we decided to work on a nest of birds at home, a whole bird. So this gives us the nest. So we went for applique because a nest is always made of pieces, box pieces from all of the feathers, the birds.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's a whole family.
Alan and Beatrice. Before you begin to even explain your garment, can we guess what it is? We've
Charlie's an eagle.
Yeah.
Except for the angel.
Yeah.
I think we came up with the inspiration mainly because of this particular fabric. It had kind of like a bag. It's not really obvious. It's more abstract. So for me, I love birds. So it just, let's do a bag. He said a hawk. No, I said a hawk. He said an eagle. So we decided to take it literally and make, because I believe eagles are very, for me, I find them smooth, swift. That is why we gave the dress this silhouette, hugging, fitting to define the woman.
And definitely rock that on stage.
We can't tell who did what, yeah? Yeah, that's what's beautiful about this garment. So you did well. Yeah, good.
So when Steve and I paired up to work, we both came with our own inspirations. He was inspired by the butterfly, and I was inspired by creating. Yeah. I was inspired by creating inner beauty that usually a person's inner beauty, you have to really get to know them and see through them well to find the inner beauty. So that's why the first sketch was a cage, and then we found that our story, our inspirations could work well together. So we created the butterfly queen inside the cage, and would like to one day get out of the cage and fly into the garden of flowers. So that's the story.
Okay.
And Steve did all the wiring, and I the wearing of the upper part and the netting and the flowers I did, and the dress was Steve.
Definitely, that explains the bottom part. Because we wondered what it was all about. Yeah. Such a challenge, but we have to come to a decision. Yeah. So, I don't like doing this. Okay. Designers, we have seen your designs. If I call your name, please step forward. And the first person or persons we'll call is Beatrice and Alan, step forward. You are safe. And you can leave the runway. The six of you who have remained have the highest and the lowest mark. One of you will be eliminated, and there will, of course, be a winner. And the winner of this challenge is Shikuku and Wendy, and the other winner of this challenge is Steven and Elsie. Ian and Lonnie. Please defend yourselves, because one of you must be eliminated today.
We work together as a team. And we came up with the concept together. And I believe, although you're saying it's wearable, I've seen people wearing a avant garde. Actually, I'm very shocked, because I thought this would be the winning piece.
Okay. Mona, defend yourself.
We came up with the concept together generally, but even from past contests, you know, Ian, so he's given the best. So as the leader of the group, because we have leadership, I had to do a lot of instruction on the garment. I did like most of the work. I instructed him, he learned a lot from me, that's true, but I did a lot of the work. He has very many ideas, but putting them together may not be his biggest strength. Doing that and also trying to figure out how I was going to finish my bottle also caused some time management issues for me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But
I believe the match of a designer is creativity, the tailoring is also a key.
Who stitched the top?
I stitched the top. I did, although there was a lot of instruction, redo the zip, redo it, but I stitched it.
But I'm the one who also came up with how the wire would get in, because he had no idea. If he had done it by himself, he probably wouldn't have come up with that wave effect, because he didn't know how to achieve some of the dramatic effect we have.
Okay.
Yeah.
So basically you did most of the work, that's what we're hearing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Not as such.
Yeah.
I believe even if the wires should not be there, I would have made it stand.
Actually, without the wires, you do not have a garment.
What we shall do now, we shall just ask you and Ian to just leave the room for like a minute, and we'll call you back.
If I may say something,
yeah.
If I didn't put the wire, I would have done it for me.
It's okay.
Hey.
Room.
Yeah.
Did you know how to insert the boning?
Can we please have the designers back?
Designers, we have made our decisions. Ian, you're very creative. Your excuse in this runway has always been about execution. We're tired of hearing of that. Lorna, we have seen your designs in the past. You have played it safe throughout. You are good in your execution. But you're very weak in your creativity. So our question was, who stays behind? We came to a conclusion. Ian, we're sorry. You're still in the competition.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I really improved and it will improve. And thanks to my teammate, also the team leader. And don't worry, and she'll go far.
And Lorna, you need to learn from this, is that we saw the creativity side of Ian in that garment. You taught him, or you were leading him in executing this garment, which I think was your weak part.
Personally, I don't know what these judges want anymore, as in, on a serious note. You know, avant-garde is subjective anyway, it's art. It's your perception. Maybe they just don't like our art. Because I think we did a good job, generally, to portray what we wanted to do. We're not out to compare ourselves with anyone else. I think Kenyans will relate a lot to what we did.
Yeah, I totally agree with that.
Mm-hmm.
And even you at the bottom,
mm-hmm.
We do stand with our design.
Yeah.
You know, we still be there.
I don't think I would have been able to work with any of the other stuff.
All the best. All the best. Thanks.
Oh, yeah.
Next week on Safari Fashion.
Today's challenge is to design something that identify Kenyan.
There's a lot of things that identify us as Kenyan, and let's say you can't miss something at the end of the day.
Wow. Although I had, you know, I was trying to debate, is it a day look? Is it an evening look?